not a single day that passes without you on my mind. Not even 1 minute can end up before.
Hello, it's not just getting you here. I'm so excited to see you yet again. We are here, we are back. If you're new to the channel, thanks for coming, thanks for subscribing. It means the world to me that you're here. Listen, we got so much to talk about. Let's get started. Simply Passionate Life, we already know what it's about, or you should know. If you don't, go to our intro video and check it out. We're all about living in the moment and enjoying every moment for what it's worth, an opportunity to love and be loved. So what are some things that snag us in that? Last week we talked about fear and how fear is a huge snag to living a Simply Passionate Life. So go back and watch that video if you didn't catch up with that. Today we're gonna be talking about the cousin of fear, which is doubt. Fear usually is kind of easy to spot out, but doubt usually is masked as very cautious or maybe a what if, or you really analyze situations. But doubt can creep in and can really impact the way we think about not only our situation, but ourselves. We have to remember that we should know who we are. Doubt makes you not know who you are. Know that you are beautifully and wonderfully made. And that is something that is number one key doubt that can rise up in you. I'm just alright, or I'm subpar, or I wish I could be better at this or that and the other. It's good to be self-reflective, but the doubts that our minds can fill up are not of God, right? And so they don't help us propel us to live a more simply passionate life. If you doubt who you are and who you were created to be, you're never going to be able to reach out there and take opportunities and be intentional with people in your life because you doubt whether or not you even deserve those things. So doubt is one of those really sneaky things that can creep in and impact us. It makes us see what we see and believe something else. And my story regarding doubt is that I have had times in my life where I doubted who I was. I doubted who God made me to be. I doubted what I was capable of just because of what I was doing in life or what my behaviors were doing. And what I want to talk about today is how can you know yourself and then believe what you know and not let doubt creep in. It's so important to know that we're children of God. We were created in the image of God. Realizing first who you are outside of what you do. Who are you? Think of times now, think of a time that you felt like you were most comfortable in your skin. What were you doing at that time? Or if I asked you to describe yourself without using any roles, would you be able to do that? Who are you? And I am goofy, I'm clumsy, I talk really, really fast, I love fitness, and I love making people laugh. I laugh when people laugh, I cry when people cry. That's who I am. Outside of the fact that I'm a counselor and a YouTuber, that's who I am, and I can't doubt that that's how God created me. Otherwise, I won't go for the opportunities that He brings my way. I will doubt who I am and whether or not I'm capable or willing to do those things. So that goes into the second doubt. We not only doubt who we are, we doubt what we're capable of. We don't know that we're capable of loving, capable of trying again, capable of forgiving, capable of reaching new heights. There's so much that we're capable of, but we doubt. And we know what we see in front of us, and we either are afraid of it, like we talked about last week, or we just doubt it. Like, is that really true? Am I really deserving of all of this that has come my way? And the answer is no. We don't deserve all the great things that come our way, but we have them. And are we capable of embracing them? The answer to that is yes. So grace is there for all of us. And even though sometimes we think we're not worthy of it, doesn't mean that God still decided to bless us with it. So don't let, you know, that feeling of unworthiness crowd out the feeling of gratitude of the grace that we are given each day. Those doubts are pretty sneaky. So we doubt who we are, we doubt what we're capable of, and we doubt our future. We talked about fear last week, and fear can cause you to be afraid of greatness and what you can do. And that's the same with doubt. Doubt comes in and makes you doubt that the things that you're dreaming of or working on are actually going to happen. So, you know, fear causes you to not do it at all. But doubt is one of those things that causes you to do it a little less subpar. A little, I don't even know if this is really going to happen this time around. I'm gonna work out, but then I'm gonna eat some Krispy Kreme because I doubt I'm gonna lose this weight anyway. Stop the doubt. Don't doubt your future. Your future is bright. The word says he has a plan for your life, plans to prosper you, not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Jeremiah 29:11. There is a future for you. Don't doubt it. Don't doubt what you can do. You know, fear is a little more of a Debo. Like I used last week, I talked about fear being a big old sumo wrestler. Well, doubt is that little bitty Tinkerbell that comes in and creeps in. Swat. Tinkerbell, doubt, out of there. And live your life simply and passionately. Be intentional. Be proactive. Be persistent. Know that in everything, there's no reason to doubt. Just trust. So, I hope you all enjoyed this video. Make sure that you subscribe below, share, tag a friend that needs to know what we're talking about. And y'all can have this conversation and keep this conversation going in your home, school, and work. Tell me what you think about the channel. What do you want to talk about? What are some things that you have let doubt creep in? And now you're saying, no longer, no more doubt, just trust. See y'all next week.